Hi, today we're talking about set theory, in particular sets and some examples. The set of real numbers basically means any number that doesn't have an imaginary component. Imaginary component means you'll see the lowercase I represents the square root of negative one. Complex numbers have both real and imaginary components. So you'll see something like A plus B I, or A minus B I. A minus B I is referred to as the complex conjugate of A plus B I, but that's another story. Rational numbers are any numbers that can be expressed as the ratio of integers. So that looks like P over Q. P is an element of the integers, and that's what it looks like. Q is also an element of the integers. That's what this little E represents. That's the symbol for element of. Let me go back here. Real numbers, this is the symbol. Complex numbers, this is the symbol. That's supposed to look like a C. Rational numbers, well, R is already taken, so rational numbers, the symbol is a Q. And that, I believe, comes from the term quotient. Irrational numbers are any numbers that are not rational. So sometimes the way this is symbolized is all reals, the set of all reals, not rational. This backwards slash represents not. So you start with a set of reals and then you remove the set of rationals. Now, there are also things called subsets, and a subset is basically a set taken from a set. A subset can be equal to the original set, if A is a subset of S, but usually subsets are smaller than the set they're taken from. Examples of subsets, right here, we've got integers, okay? So an example of integers are the subset, are a subset, sorry, of the real numbers. And of course, there are more real numbers than there are integers. Integers, basically, it is any positive or negative number, including zero, that doesn't have any decimals after it. Some people call them round numbers. Other examples of subsets. A subset of the integers are the natural numbers. Some people would call them counting numbers. In general, they are non-negative. Sometimes zero is included and sometimes not. But if you wanted to show that the natural numbers are a subset from the integers, you would say natural numbers are an element of Z, or N is in Z, sometimes they'll say, or the natural numbers are in the integers. There's also, sometimes you'll see sets of ordered pairs. So in other words, you might take the integers and you might set them up. All the combinations of the integers, let's say, and then you would have X, Y, and I think that looks like, if you're doing integers, you would have Z cross Z. And that gives you, you'd be in sort of a Z2 thing, meaning two-dimensional two-dimensional space. Now, the reason we define sets, define has two meanings in math. It's either an explanation of something, and you can have formal definitions, which either mean the official definition of something, or it also means a definition that is a formula. But then usually in mathematics, when you hear the term define, it means to set something. You're defining a set, or you're defining a function. For example, right here, f of x. You could define that function as y, or f of x equals x squared. So you take the input x, you square it, and then you would get y here, the output. Where you're coming from is your domain. Where you are going to, or the set of things that you define as where things are going to, is called the codomain. And this is sometimes confused with the term range. Range means if you take your subset here, you perform your function, you get all of the outputs, and that is your range. But your range is usually smaller than your codomain, so it's an element of the codomain. And I like to a lot of times when you see a professor talk about subsets on the board. Now, our natural instinct as interpreters is to take a set here, and then we think subset. There's something, you know, we might have a set and then pull it down and have a subset here. But really, in mathematics, that's not what it looks like. In mathematics, you'll see, a Venn diagram, perhaps, and a subset is always within the larger set. And remember, it would be denoted this way. The subset A is an element or exists within the set S. That's all I got for today. If you have any questions or suggestions, I hope you will let me know. And if I could just get out of here, that'd be awesome. All right.